cinematic video by using a free software. It's just like a dream for every content creators. In this video, we're gonna take a look at the video proc blogger.
Creating a video by using a free software is just like a dream for beginners if that software doesn't require a heavy configuration PC or laptop. In this video, we're gonna take a look at the Video Proc Blogger, which is one of the best free video editing software for absolute beginners. It has all the necessary tools that can be used to edit any kind of video project. So let's see how to edit a cinematic video inside of it. Alright, so this is the Video Proc Blogger, and here we have the project window. You can set your project name, location, resolution and frame rate, and once you have done your setting, you can click on the new project button. And this is the Video Proc Blogger interface, and interface is pretty simple as you can see. Here we have the media library. You can add your media files from here by clicking on this plus button. And this is the transition section where we have so many different type of video transition. You can use these transition on your video clip. And this is the title. So if you want to create some animated titles on your video, you can simply drag and drop from here and you can customize it by yourself. And this is the effect section where we have so many different type of video effect. So we have the fire effect. We have all the fireworks, ghost, glitch and so many different type of video effect. Now let's go to the next window, which is the preview window, and this is the property window where you can change your video setting, and this is the timeline. So as you can see, we have the video track, the overlay track and the audio track. You can add the tracks according to you by clicking on this plus button. So if you want to add new overlay track, you can simply add a new overlay track from here, and you can also delete the empty track. And as you see, we have all the necessary tools. So you can lock your video track, you can hide the track, and you can mute the track sound from here. And here we have the opacity and volume control as well, and here we have the different type of tools such as the color, motion, crop, speed, cut, split. Set the project resolution from here as well, and this is the export button. So once you have done your editing, you can simply click on the export button and save your project as a video format. So it is very simple, as you can see. Now let's quickly edit a cinematic video. So just go to the media library, and I'm gonna add some video clips over here. So click on the plus button. Let's go to the location. So here we have the video and the audio clips. So select all the files and click on open. I'm gonna use the audio track first. So let's drag and drop the audio track on the audio track layer, just like that. Just place the CTI, current time indicator, over here. This is the split button. Click on the split button and delete the extra unwanted part by hitting backspace or delete button. Let's drag the audio track and place it over here, or you can also simply right click on the blank area and click on the ripple delete. Perfect. Now I want to add the fade in and fade out effect. So select the audio track, go to the property window, and here we have the volume, and here we have the fade in effect and the fade out. So let's set the fade in value maybe 1.5 and fade out value 1. You can set the value according to you. Let's arrange this video clip on the timeline. So it's very simple. You can simply drag and drop the video clip on the timeline. Let's reduce the speed and make it cinematic. So select the video clip, go to the property window, and inside of the property window, we have so many different type of parameter. So the first parameter is for opacity. You can adjust the opacity of the video clip from here. And this is the color filter. You can adjust the color like exposure, contrast, saturation, or you can also explore the color correction tool from here. And this is the transform. You can adjust the scale, rotation, position, etc. And here we have the fade in and out effect as well. If you want to reverse the video clip, you can simply check this box. And this is the play speed. In this case, I want to reduce the speed of the video and make it cinematic. So I'm going to click on the 1/4 because the frame rate of the video clip is 100 FPS. It means we can reduce the speed 1/4. And here we have the non-linear editor as well. Now let's cut the best part of the video clip. So place the CDI over there and click on split. Now delete the unwanted part. This is the first clip. You can do some setting with the clip. So select the clip and I'm gonna adjust the color a little bit. So this is the saturation. You can increase the saturation just a little bit. So I'm gonna set the value maybe 15. And here we have the color and filter editor. So you can add wingate effect. So here we have the wingating. You can reduce the value. Now it's looking perfect. You can click on the apply. You can tweak this color setting from here as well. So you can simply click on the color and you can adjust these settings from here, or you can also apply a specific color. So we have lots of color preset over here. All right, so this is the first clip. Now let me quickly arrange all the clips on the timeline by using the same technique. So let's do it in fast forward. And now I want to mute the attached audio. So it's very simple. You can simply click on the mute button. Now let me do some color correction with these clips. So first one is looking good. Select the second clip and just go to the property window. And here we have the saturation. Let's increase the saturation a little bit. So I'm gonna set the value maybe 15 and click on the color and filter editor. Here we have the wingating. Let's set the value maybe negative 30 and do the same thing for all the clip. So let's do it quickly. All right, so everything is done. And now I want to apply a transition on this last video clip. So just go to the transition section and here we have the fade to black transition. Simply we have to drag the fade to black transition and drop it on this last clip. And let's take a look. All right, it's looking perfect. I want to add a video effect at the beginning of this cinematic video. So just go to the effect section and here we have so many different type of effect as you can see. Let's drag and drop any video effect at the beginning. Here we have the glitch effect. Let's drag and drop the glitch effect over here. And as you can see, we will get the video effect. But I think we don't need any video effect on this cinematic video. So let's delete by hitting backspace button, or you can also click on the delete button to delete the video effect or video track. All right. And now let me add a title over here. So just go to the title section and here we have so many different type of video title. So let's drag and drop the first one. So simply drag the title and drop it on this overlay track. And here we have the title. So select the title and let's customize it by yourself. So I'm gonna type the cinematic. Go to the second title and let's hit backspace to delete them. And this is the first title. Let's select your favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using the Architect Bold font style. You can set the style from here. And this is the size of the text. So I'm going to set the size 72 pixel, maybe 100. Perfect. And now we have to align the text in the center. We can adjust the animation of the title. So simply click on the edit text and here we have the animation. We have to click on the none because we don't need any animation. If you need any animation on the text, you can simply select any animation that you like. So in this case, I want to click on the none, click on apply. Or you can also customize the text inside of the edit text. So we have lots of options as you can see. So you can change any text style from here or you can make it by yourself. So we have lots of different parameters. You can simply adjust the title and click on apply. Now let me show you how you can save the project. So this is the video proc option. You can click on the option and here we have the new project, open project. In this case, I want to save the project. So you can click on simply save project I want to export this project as a video file, so click on the export. We have to do some settings, so I'm going to type the cinematic video. After that, we have to select the location, so click on this button and click on select folder, and here we have to select the format, which is the most important. So in this case, I want to export this video clip in the mp4 format, so select the mp4, and here you can select the quality. So I'm gonna select the quality high. You can check this option as well, high quality engine lossless mode, and you can select the codec. So in this case, I want to use this AVC H264, and here we have the frame rate. So in this case, I want to render this cinematic video in 30 frames per second, or 24 frames per second is pretty good. So you can select the 24 frames per second, and here we have the audio option. So leave the audio setting as it is, click on start. Now it's done, as you can see, and here we have the cinematic video. So let's see the cinematic video. Alright, so it's looking absolutely perfect, and as you can see, we have lots of tools inside of this free software. So in my opinion, this is the best video editing software for absolute beginner. The best thing is that it is absolutely free. So just go to the link in the description and download this free video editing software. This video editing software doesn't require any heavy configuration system. You can simply run this software on any kind of laptop or any low configuration PC as well. And that is it for now, guys. I hope you like this video. If you have any question, drop a message on my Instagram or comment down below. My name is Vikash, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.